Hello my dear students, this is your guide and mentor for organic chemistry. We are taking videos on isomerism, and in our last video we have talked about chain isomerism and positional isomerism. In this video we will be talking about functional isomerism and metamerism. Let us start with our topic. Then you have the third one, which is called as functional. This is many a time student gets confused with something like this. These are those functional groups which can be interconvertible. You know, they have the same, hum bolte na, they have to have something same. They have the same molecular formula. Of course, all of them have the same, but the structural formula is slightly different. They have the same molecular formula. Now look at this, they have different functional groups. For example, if I write something like this, have a look at this, C2H5O C2H5, and if I write something like this, C4H9OH, have a look at both of them. This is example of an alcohol, this is example of an ether. We know that ether is a derivative of alcohol. Ether is prepared from alcohol. And look at the molecular formula of these two. Suppose I write it as a whole, C2 matlab C4, H5 plus 5H10 and O. Here also C4, H10, 9 plus 1, 10 and O. So they have the same formula, but they have different functional groups. Hence they are referred to as functional isomers. Another example of functional isomer can be given as aldehyde or ketone. Have a look at this example. For example, this is acetone, CH3, C double bond O, CH3. This is acetone. If I take something like this, C2H5, C double bond OH. And now look at the molecular formula. See, this is ketone, this is aldehyde. If I look at the molecular formula, this is nothing but C2H6O C3 C3H6O, and look at this, C3H5 plus 1 6 and O. So both of them have the same molecular formula, but they have different functional groups. One has ketone, one has aldehyde. So such isomers are referred to as functional isomers. My dear students, we should not get confused with functional isomers and metamerism, because this is also shown by compounds like ether and ketone only. Because both the examples, these functional groups match, students get confused. Don't get confused. Now, what do you mean by metamerism? Metamerism is not about having the different functional groups. It is shown by those compounds जिसमें, for example, ऐसे functional groups हैं जो के आपके alkane की chain को cleave कर रहे, बीच में से काट दे रहे. जैसे कि देखिए, ketone आपके alkane की chain को काट दे रहे, या फिर ether आपके alkane के chain को काट दे रहे. तो ऐसे compounds show metamerism. Now what is metamerism? Have a look. For example, this is one ether, which is diethyl ether. If I can write like this, CH3O C3H7, which is nothing but methyl propyl ether. If the same, but the total number of carbons are same, four here, but the chains are different on both the sides of the functional group. ये उन्हीं functional groups में दिखाते हैं जहाँ पर functional group is cleaving a molecule. या फिर यहाँ पर, या तो मैंने the simplest example लिया, acetone. Acetone cannot show this isomerism. Instead, if I would have taken C2H5 here, right, then I could have again seen something like this, CH3, C double bond O, C3H7. तो जो alkane की chain है, that is alkyl की जो chain है, that is different in the on both the sides of the cleaving. जैसे कि ether में या फिर ketone में. Such a phenomenon is referred to as metamerism. Such a phenomenon is referred to as metamerism. In our next video, we will be talking about tautomerism and what is a stereoisomers. Thank you. Keep watching. Don't forget to subscribe this channel.